So now that we know how to solve quadratic equations, let's try some quick applications. All right, an envelope's length is 4 centimeters more than its width. The area is 96 centimeters squared. Find the length and width. All right, so since we're dealing with length and width, we want to define them and assign a variable to it. So for length, we're going to use L, and for width, we'll use W. All right, and since we have two variables, we need two equations. So let's look at our first sentence. It says an envelope's length. We just have to translate. So the length is L. Is equals, and then it's 4 centimeters. More than means plus, and width we're assigned W. So there we go. L equals 4 plus W. Okay, let's move on to the next sentence. It says the area is 96 centimeters squared. Well, the formula for area is length times width. And for the values that we've been given, we are given an area of 96. And now that we have two equations, we can solve it. So we'll use substitution. Let's write 96 equals L times W. And the reason I'm writing this equation first is this one's already set up as L equals this, which will allow me to plug it in for the L very cleanly. So 96 equals, parentheses for the L, 4 plus W and W. And then there's our quadratic. It's very similar to what you see here, this one. So we're going to have to distribute, bring over the 27, and then factor and set each equal to 0. So let's try that. Let's distribute. Bring the 96 over. Let's rewrite this in descending order. So W squared plus 4W minus 96. And there we go. So now we're going to factor it. So 96 would be plus 12 and minus 8. And then we set them equal to 0. And there's your two answers. Okay, now which one of these is a possible width? It's that one. Can't have negative widths. So that one's crossed off. So now that we know W is 8, we just use the same rules we've used for the substitution method, and we plug it back in for length. So length equals 4 plus W, which is 4 plus 8, which is 12. So that means we have a length of 12 centimeters and a width of 8 centimeters. And then we still have to check it to make sure it fits everything. So is the length 4 more than the width? Yes. If we multiply them together, because that's our area, 12 times 8, do we get 96? Yes, we do. It checks out. So that is our answer. All right. Let's see if you can try it again. This is a very similar problem. Just change the words around. Let's see if you can try this one. Hit pause and give it a shot. Okay, if you're still kind of struggling, you should have gotten this. Length and width, obviously. And then the base of a cardboard box has a width, right there, that is 4 feet less than its length. And less than, you got to switch them. It's not 4 minus, it's minus 4. All right, and then the area is 117, right there. All right, so try substitution now and see if you can solve it. And there's what you should have gotten. So 13 and 9 were a possible length. Negative 9 were a possible lengths, and negative 9 doesn't work. So 13 would be our answer. Plugging it back in, we get 13 minus 4, which is 9. And that means 9 is 4 less than 13. And if we check it by multiplying, 9 times 13 is 117. So there we go. All right, last one. This is a slightly different one. This is an object being dropped from a height of 64 feet. How long will it take to hit the ground? So this is our position function. This is for feet. And what happens is S is your position, so S is our height. Okay? It's the height off the ground. So at the ground level, your height would equal 0, right? So if you drop an object, it goes down, boom, hits the ground. That's a height of 0, and we're dropping it from a height of 64 feet. Okay, so if you were to plug in 64 feet, it would tell you how long it takes to get to 64 feet, which is nothing, zero. And if you plug in zero, the time will tell us how long it will take for this object to get to a height of zero, which is the ground, and that's what we're looking for. So if you plug in zero, we have our equation. So let's factor it. In fact, there's a nice little trick. We're going to divide by negative 16 this time, because they all contain a 16. What's 64 divided by 16? 4. So we will get 0 equals t squared minus 4. And there's a nice factorable form. So it's t minus 2, t plus 2. T minus 2 equals 0, t plus 2 equals 0. And there it is again. Again, we don't have negative time. So time is 2. 2 what? Seconds. This is always going to be in seconds. So it takes 2 seconds to hit the ground. And that's it. So whenever they're asking you to find how long it takes to hit the ground, you make S equal to 0. Thank you.